So trailer just pulled in and they are actually surrendering 5 horses today. And they're just in the office doing some paperwork. So let's see what happens. Kimberly's trying to get all the halters off before we can turn them loose.
Yeah. Okay, so Mama, and then you said the name of the woman with the stick was what? With the 4 black feet?
Easier said than done sometimes.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Okay.
These horses kind of are a really sad story. So for over 20 years, this man and his wife were raising Arabian horses, and some of these horses would last babies, so they didn't keep raising them, but they kept them and they loved them. And his wife of 44 years passed away, and that is so sad. And she loved watching our TV show and the episodes, and she told him that when she was gone, she wanted her horses to come here. And you know, she's obviously just loved these horses, took really good care of them. And stories like this are really sad. I was talking to him about what his other options were if we weren't here, and he said there was really no options. And his biggest thing is he didn't want them, and she didn't want them to go to slaughter. And that's why they liked our organization, is because we rescue horses from getting shipped to slaughter, and we don't want any horse to go to slaughter. He was just extremely grateful that we were here, and it's really sad case, but I'm thankful that we were here to help them. And now we're gonna turn them out. They've been here for a little bit, they settled down, and I bet they're gonna be very happy to run. Some of these horses were born on the property and have never been in a trailer or off site until today. So it's really nice to see them running and happy and free here. When I was born, my family had Arabian horses, my mom raised Arabian horses, so one of my favorite horses, her name was Katezza, and she reminds me a lot of the flea-bitten one there in the back. There's not a whole lot of Arabian horses we see here in Tennessee, but when we do, it always kind of takes me back to the Arabian horses that we had when I was a kid. Yeah, they're beautiful animals.
So today we are setting up pool noodles. We got a bunch delivered through the Amazon wish list. If you're watching this, please no more pool noodles. We got plenty. I'm gonna take them all out, but first I'm gonna drink my coffee. And if you're wondering why I look like this, I am completely congested right now. I don't know what's going around, but something is going around. I don't have a fever, so I'm here. I'm gonna drink this first.
Me and me get the door.
Let's go over
here. So we do have this barrel we could store them in. For the ones I'm not using, I'm just gonna keep them in the bag so that they could last a little bit longer. It does look like we have 2 different types. There's these ones that have the lot smaller holes. I think those will work good for the standing noodle obstacle. And then the bigger ones I could use on the PVC pipe and the ones we gotta screw off. And these guys have been on here for about 2 years. Thank you. Yeah. I'm gonna need to get the drill. So I'm just gonna do one screw in here right now. And this just kind of helps hold this noodle on there. So if a horse goes blowing through it, they stay on. Horses mainly see in blues and yellows. So like these colors to them kind of show up gray. Don't quote me on that though, do your own research. Either way, it's pretty interesting stuff. All right, those ain't going nowhere. On to the next one. So these have the smaller holes. So I'm hoping that'll allow this to kind of stick a little bit better. Because this obstacle, we've had a big issue with the noodles just wanting to fall off. And that's it. Eventually I will set the cowboy curtain back up, but I gotta figure out what I'm gonna use because the baling twine I had on there, it worked great for about 6 months. And then it started to get brittle and break, but I'll look into that and probably get that set up too.
The farrier is going to be here in a little bit, so we're pulling up all the horses and getting them ready. These horses came in as owner surrenders earlier this week. We have their kennel cards printed out because we're trying to figure out exactly who's who. There's four grays that look almost identical. Some of them are a little bit lighter and they have all slightly different markings, so we're going to figure out who's who. The bay is Summer. The dark flea bitten gray with the snip, I think that's the closest one. That's a lullaby. Yeah, lullaby.
Makes sense. These are all just trims in here?
Yeah, these are all just trims. They're not terribly long, but some of them are pretty chippy, so.
Cool.
Look at them drop off. You need some fly boots, miss. And according to the guy who dropped them off, which was actually like their farrier transporting for them, he said they were fine for their feet.
Okay.
I'm not sure if he also is the one who said they might need time to get used to a new person, but he said they were great.
Okay.
Corey just tested out that one and she picked up her feet just fine, so.
Cool, hopefully we'll not have any issues.
Between the lines. Jason.
She was fine. We'll see how this one is. They're all extremely buddy sour.
That's okay, not gonna
so
happen.
She is her baby.
Okay.
She is her baby, and they're like 20 something, so that could cause problems.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
You could try her. It's probably just because they're so buddy sour right now. This is Wisteria. She is a 27-year-old Arabian. They all came in together. They're all related except for the bay. And unfortunately, the downside to that is that two of these horses are her babies and they've been with her since they've been born, presumably. And they're like 20 years old. So they've never been weaned at like 20 and they're all super buddy sour. So they're screaming and causing problems.
I think I'm gonna call her Hysteria.
Yeah, I don't really want to work on her if she's going to be acting like
that.
Yeah,
they're making threats now, so.
Spend an hour fighting her.
The previous farrier said they were great. I'm like, I'm going to need context next time. Great under what situation? And they've probably never been restrained before. Yeah, because they've never left the property. I think the guy said it was the first time they were ever on a trailer.
Yeah.
At 20 something.
Today is Farrier Day, and we are working first on five new. They were owner surrenders. They're Arabians. They've been together their whole life. So we're kind of managing them. They're in a completely new place. They're just getting settled in. And while they're new, we're going to go ahead and finish their intake after Elijah gets done with their farrier work today. So we'll do their vaccines, their coggins, their microchips, whole nine yards, and get those finished up. And after those five, we are going to do a Mary needs a shoe reset. Ginger gets her cast off today, and we'll see who all else we get done today.
So this is Wisteria. She is the mom of Bella and I think Tessa, who are full siblings. They're all related. Unfortunately, her two babies have never been weaned from her. So she's 27 and they're like 20 something. But yeah, thankfully they've only needed a light sedation dose. It's basically because they're pretty good for their feet. They're just buddy sour and they won't stand still. So hopefully next time we can use Dorm gel. And if we figure out their behavioral issues, we can get back down to where we don't need any.
So just finished trimming Wisteria. We did have to sedate her. She was acting a little ornery, but with sedation she was good. She was got a little heavy, but she didn't act up at all. She behaved well, so it was a success.
Ginger, we're actually going to take her cast off today, and Ginger, I can tell we're hopefully where we want to be at with her, because she is not laying around her stall like she had been before. So she's done really well with the cast on, with that short extension a little longer. So we're going to take it off and see how she does without it.
She's not knuckling over though. Not least when she stands like that.
It's like a mule foot.
Yeah, she's high. Easy, easy, easy. Hold up.
It kind of just grew straight out. And it's so tiny. Like keeping it casted up kept it from like...
Yeah, it didn't flare at all.
Flaring at all. Yeah. It's okay. You're doing great. You're super impressed. You're better behaved than those big ol' Arabians.
It's off already. Yes.
She's looking pretty good. Yeah, she's got a stupid amount of length. She still needs to get trimmed down.
And it like stayed tiny because it was all kind of like bound up in the cast.
Oh my goodness, sweetheart.
It's a little mule foot.
Okay, sweetie.
She's sitting on it and she's not knuckling over.
Let's walk her up and down a little bit and see how she does.
All right, did you still need to take?
We still need a trimmer all the way around. I do need to trim more on that foot, but I dropped her heels by maybe a half inch as opposed to where they were, so she's already sitting a little lower than.
That's some good progress. So, yeah, I'll let you go ahead and finish trimming her up. And what we'll do today is let her hang out in the stall, and then tomorrow we'll try her out about 30 minutes, and then we'll go from there. So, perfect, darling.
How about it, baby?
Hey, sweetie, I know.
You got a foot.
I know. Nothing on there either.
It's functional.
We'll take a mule foot.
It's not beautiful yet, but it's functional.
It's okay, sweetheart.
It doesn't have to be beautiful.
It doesn't have to be perfect. Again, we'll take little blemishes.
Yeah.
Function is always better than looks.
We're eager to move around, but... I wonder how much of the toe is still our glue.
About that much. You can kind of see from the bottom. It's not. No. And her hoof wall up here is good and straight, so it's not like. Yeah. Yeah. Most of that is trimmed out. This isn't all that thick at this point. She's good. So just finished Ginger. This is the first time we tried working on her without sedation out of the stocks. She did great. She behaved very well. We were able to get her toe extension off and she's standing flat. Everything's looking great, really as good as we could have hoped for. So this is a big win for sure.
Hey, you want to run around a little bit? It's a little bigger than the stall. Yeah, she's still kind of landing with her toe.
Yeah.
But hopefully.
You gotta get used to it a little bit. You're still better than we were, so. We're still better than we were.
That's a nice quarter horse.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So cute. My goodness.
Going to everyone's hands.
I know.
She's like, where's the treats at, people?
Do you have food? Alms for the poor?
Okay, sweetie.
Do you have food?
Yeah, you don't have food. Okay, we got donkey to do still. Corey, if you're going to be down here, if you don't care, put her back up in about 10 minutes, and then tomorrow we'll let her have more time out. I am happy with Ginger today. She got her cast off. Elijah finished trimming up her other feet. So we put her in the round pen for just a few minutes, see how she done. Of course, being her, she's like, anybody got anything to eat? So, but she's looking good. We'll keep an eye on her. We're gonna let her exercise more starting tomorrow in the round pen, just give her some more freedom of movement. And we'll just watch her. And then she should about be ready then. So got all good news for Ginger. So it's been a long journey since January, but we're about where we need to be, so good.
Just a donkey with very long feet. He's slippered on all four.
Nice. So,
I remembered he was good when we done x-rays and got Coggins. That's why I was like, I remember him being decently good. Okay, he's good.
Not every day you get to work on a project like this, right?
I wish that was the case.
Oh, you do get a project like this every day?
Not every day, but more frequently than I'd care for.
That's too bad.
Yeah. Oh, none of that.
We're probably gonna need more, just venturing a guess. He's still trying to run away, so. It wasn't actually as like nearly as bad as it looked on the x-rays. So we're hoping we'll be able to trim him up and he'll be okay.
Nippers in this foot.
Yeah, just as far down as you can go every time.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
They're shorter. They're still twisted as all get out. I don't think there's anything we can do about that.
It's basically fly repellent. Like donkeys, for some reason, they don't like stomp to get the flies off the way horses do. So a lot of times they'll like get really chewed up by the flies on their legs and their ears especially. You know, for some reason they don't struggle the way horses do against the flies. So they just let them eat them alive. It is not Pepto-Bismol. It is actually, it's actually SWAT. It's just Pepto-Bismol colored. What are you doing?
Either that or he's trying,
are you trying to bite
my
him?
Throat out.
Yeah, watch him. I don't like the way his head is. Yeah,
he's trying to turn around. Just let me get out of here.
He's pretty close to done with that.
He's
foot
like
anyway.
Able to like stretch and keep pulling and pulling and get slack. That's how that ended up happening.
Yeah, I don't trust his face that close to yours.
Let me just move this up.
That wasn't a terribly friendly sound he was making either.
No, I was like, that's not the thing to be, yeah.
I don't need to go kissing any donkeys today.
reach out and try to bite my leg as I was trying to resedate it while I was trying to castrate it. There so I don't ever trust that? It. I was back home and I was castrating it was a mean jack. And I was having to resedate it, and the thing literally tried to bite my boot as I was resedating it.
Wow.
Yes.
It's impressive.
You know what? I think he's good.
And you're not worried about it?
Yeah, I was just about finished with it, I don't think there's enough to do there to warrant picking it back up again.
Yeah. Looks fine to me. Looks done.
Pretty happy with his rears, considering what we started with. His front feet are gonna take a...
He's like conformationally like really towed out. Yeah. Like he's like moving like this.
Yeah, he is pretty twisted.
Yeah.
So we'll see how straight we can get him over the course of a few rotations. But at least he won't be actively making himself worse anymore. Well, we just got finished trimming Knox, and he's a handful. We had him sedated pretty heavy, and he still fought us every step of the way. His feet are a mess. He's in rough shape, but we did get him trimmed. He is better, and now it's just a matter of time and keeping up with it and seeing what we can improve. The day overall went really well. We got plenty done, and very excited about the success we've had with Ginger. She's looking good. Yeah, so definitely a successful day.
My name is Caitlin. I'm the vet assistant, and I'm also the stable hand for the vet barn. On a day-to-day basis, I clean the stalls and assist Dr. Nancy. My favorite thing about Horse Plus is everything. I probably couldn't pick one thing, but I definitely enjoy getting to see horses get a new lease on life and running in pastures and playing. I wanted to work at Horse Plus because for me, Horse Plus is heaven. I came out in November and adopted a horse, and I got to meet all the staff, and they were so sweet. So I just decided to do it. Outside of work, I don't have too many hobbies. I mainly raise a small human. She doesn't give me much time for anything else. So I'd say my only hobby is taking care of my horses and raising a small human. My favorite animal is all animals. But if I had to pick one, it would be a horse. Just because my horse that I own is so special to me. And I also have a dog.
That was some big girl stuff right there.
Peaceful Pastures Donkey Rescue is here, and they are bringing four horses to us, and they are picking up some donkeys from us to take back with them. So I'm gonna go help them get that taken care of.
I put her on the trailer to go get Coggins in the first slant, and she went crazy and beat up her face. She's claustrophobic. The vet told me that afterward. I'm like, yeah, I got that.
If you don't mind, I'll just go ahead and get photos one at a time here.
There's a medical memo about her, okay. What happened.
She is going to have to be run off the trailer because she's not halter broke.
She won't be bad.
She'll be good, but we're just going to kind of just let her run off.
That's her buddy. Her mother figure. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Bye. We're going to go look at the donkeys in the donkey pen. Come to think of it, I kind of need Kimberly to give us a little help with the donkeys. So, Dr. Nancy gave me some treats, and we'll go ahead and walk over here to the donkey's pasture.
Bozeman, Applejack, Elvis, Puppy, I don't think any of them will be terribly difficult if y'all are donkey people and know what you're doing. Applejack especially is pretty good. He's picked up his feet for me before without sedation, just like in the pasture without a halter. So That's Tyson, and that's Bozeman. The brown one is Bozeman.
This is Bozeman here.
Applejack's very much like, in your face, give me attention. I love people. This is
the great. Only thing I'm concerned about is the ones that we have to like really, we know we're going to have to really sedate because
yeah.
It's really difficult. I would have to transport them an hour and a half to get to the vet and take Kendra with me. So
yeah.
I don't think that we're going to be able to do that. But any of the others, I think, would be fine.
Yeah, these three, I guess the donks,
yeah,
are, I think you're going to have pretty good luck with if you know what you're doing.
Yeah.
Picking up, like, Applejack, I'm pretty sure he'll be fine. I picked up his feet in the stall without sedation, and he didn't do anything. Peppy is a little more shy, especially with the hind end. And Bozeman, we've used, like, basic sedation, but I think he had a pretty low dose for a donkey, from what I remember. So.
And we usually can get around sedation with those that.
Yeah, I think you can work with all three of those.
He's all drunk, too drunk for you to really see his personality.
You can tell he's got pretty good scrotal swelling, but the good thing is it's all solid. My main part is your guts trying to come out now, but they're not. It's just the he did bleed pretty good, so, but. But yeah, other than the extreme amount, which still is not maxed out and the worst I've ever seen, so.
He's not as bad as some of them that we've seen, but he is pretty swollen.
Yep. That's one of the worst ones I've seen, but I bet y'all get probably more.
They just love to bleed, even.
It's the one that hemorrhage, yeah. And that's only happened to two of them when we've castrated 100 at least or more, but. He always ties them off now after that first hemorrhage.
I started doing that more just as a routine, just to, when they pulled off in my hand, one of them did on Applejack.
Oh.
The second one, I was not even done. I just got ready to start stripping, pulled off. So, and then I went, he was in that stall, got him finished, went on to the next one, to Pepe. We were trying to go to auction that day. Well, then his first one pulled off in my hand. And I was like, I had two more lined up. I'm like, we're done. We're stopping for the day. We're going on auction.
You can look at him in the morning and see what you think.
Yeah, and also, like, you might want to evaluate his personality. He's got a big personality.
Yeah.
It's not bad. He's just, like, very loud and...
He was a ladies'
man. He likes to sing to us in the mornings.
Yes. He literally tried to breathe through any border fence.
Like, that's why he was in quarantine pasture 3 by himself, because we had to put an entire pasture between him and anything that was a girl, because he would try to mount things through the panels.
Yeah, so.
He had serious problems.
I'm Kendra with Peaceful Pastures Donkey Rescue.
And I'm Beth with Peaceful Pastures Donkey Rescue.
We are doing a shelter transfer. We had four horses that we had at our facility, and people don't come to us for horses, they come to us for donkeys. So therefore we feel like this was a better option to give them the best chance possible to find a good supportive home. We are coming back tomorrow to pick up a few donkeys to take back to Missouri with us.
Okay, what? No, give me a second, go away. All right, okay. All right, I'm Isabella. I'm usually behind the camera, so this is really weird for me, but I'm adopting Coco today. She's a dog, and she's wonderful. But yeah, so I'm gonna fill out some paperwork, and I'm gonna go get her. Hi, Rebecca.
Hello.
So I'm getting Coco, as you know. Mm-hmm. So what do I need to do?
We're gonna have to do a few things.
Okay. I've never done this before.
You've not adopted one yet?
No.
So many years of experience.
Oh my gosh.
Well, here is Coco's paperwork. Okay. Coco is now part of your family, and you can move her photo over from looking for love to found love.
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank you. All right. Look at how cute she is. I love this photo so much. Hold on. I can't do this. What the heck?
They make it look so easy. Okay. I got all the paperwork done and everything. It's the end of the day, so I'm gonna get my stuff together and then I'm gonna go get Coco.
Hi, honey.
Hi. Hello.
So excited.
So her name was Coco, but we are naming her Ahsoka. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna be calling her from now on.
You're so cute.
Good girl.
Good girl.
She's ready to go. So I'm gonna take her home now. And my husband and I are really excited about it.
Ahsoka,
good girl.
Today is our volunteer day, and we're so thankful to have our volunteers that have shown up today to clean and help us out around the shelter.
So right now we're basically washing out all the dishes, and she's sterilizing the dishes. I see we have more visitors coming. That's basically what we're doing. We're just washing the dishes and getting them sterilized for the animals.
When this is all done, it's your last project to get these all clean, and then we'll go groom some minis.
We're done with all this stuff. We have washed three side-by-sides, and it seems like millions of boxes, but we are done.
Side-by-sides are all cleaned, and the buckets, they did an amazing job. Now they're going over to the intake barn to do some grooming with Cowboy and Little Man. Volunteer Day is in the bag for June, and we got a lot of stuff cleaned. Cowboy and Little Man got groomed, and we are so thankful for all of our volunteers.
Thank you for having us.
Peaceful Pastures is here and they're doing a shelter transfer. They did bring us some ponies and now they're gonna be taking some of our long ears. While the donkeys are getting loaded up, we're gonna bring them into our studio and find out how it's been doing piloting a Full Circle Life horse shelter.
My name is Beth Hakala. I'm with Peaceful Pastures Donkey Rescue.
And I'm Kendra Bench and I'm with Peaceful Pastures Donkey Rescue.
Since boot camp, we have changed a number of things. We started with establishing a surrender policy as well as a shelter policy, and we implemented some of the programs that the Horse Plus Humane Society uses, such as Shelter Love, which is a program that we are now going to be able to embed into our webpage and have put out our adoptable animals to the world basically on the web. We weren't ever able to do that in the past, and it also makes it easier for shelter-to-shelter transfers. We hired a doer, someone that can help us with marketing because I just don't have time and we don't really have the expertise as a group to do that. So on our social media page, mainly Facebook, we've uploaded a lot more videos, and as a result, I think we've reached more people worldwide and we've seen more supporters from different countries. We've seen people that are more interested in donkeys, and some of them actually knew they were. So I think that that's been a huge success.
Well, just the downsides is you really see who, you know, the hate that comes from just having a different philosophy or outlook on how things should be done. But there's a lot of people out there who are really, really fast to bash other rescues, along with, you know, things that your own ideals. It seems people do a lot of, research on their own. And it's not good research. They're not coming up with good information. So when you try to educate, it usually turns out to be a negative. You definitely can't make everyone happy. There's no way.
And what the important part is that we're doing what's right for the animal. And really, it doesn't matter what people think in the end. If the animal is taken care of well, is not suffering, and has the best quality of life that it can have, then, I mean, that's what we're supposed to do. So that's what we're gonna focus on. So we were pretty excited about the being in this network, and we can do shelter-to-shelter transfers fairly easily. That's very important for us because most people, or most rescues that are in the network, focus on horses and we focus on donkeys. So in our world, people come to us for donkeys. They don't really come to us for horses. So if we do get horses though sometimes, some surrenders and things like that. So if we can transfer those horses to a shelter that, you know, has more horse following, and you know, that's exciting because they'll have much better chance of getting a home. And for instance, we brought a 2-year-old draft cross who really needs a trainer and is ready to go. She's sweet, she's got a great personality, and you know, I've been watching her for some time and just thinking, I'm not doing what's best for this animal. So this transfer has really allowed me, you know, to do what's best for her and put her in a horse environment. And in return, you know, a lot of people don't focus on donkeys. So we can take donkeys that, you know, by transfer that, you know, that may not get placed in other places. And I think in that way, if we can work together as a network and a team of rescues, I think that we can do what's best for all the animals that need us.